we have signed a peace agreement. And I don't think that all those who have signed would have any reason of not moving forward. The agreement was not supposed to be signed and checked in whatever shells that we have. It is supposed to be implemented. We are here today to agree on the metrics that have been laid down by the mediation. That they know after signing the agreement, days are counted. What do we do the first day? What do we do next? What do we do? And after how many days? It is all here. And so, when we finish, if you are satisfied, I don't know, this agreement belongs to us. As I said here yesterday, you were not here. I said here yesterday that agreement belongs to us. We South Sudanese people. We must own it and implement it. This is what our people want. The sovereignty of the people is when we implement the agreement and we go for elections. This is where, you know, the people will say their word through their ballots. He whom they want, they will vote for that person. Zolema Dereno will get to know whatever number of votes that he gets, he or she. That does not mean that we are to go back to war again. It is a commitment that we must do right away from now, that, you know, we are to implement the agreement with sincerity, that, you know, after the implementation of the agreement, we go for elections. These elections, we will abide with the results of the elections. Whatever the people say, that will be the final ruling.
We started talking about the release of these groups since we first met in Addis Ababa under the auspices of the Prime Minister. So, you said you would look into it. Again, we did hear in Khartoum, and finally the phone conversation. I hope Your Excellency has taken action, because that builds confidence and trust among people when such an action is taken. I had told you many a time that we had released the number of prisoners of war that we have. We released them since December 2017. Those who were in Punia, those who were in Bangal, those who were in Ayun, and those who were in Wau, outside Wau. And I also inform you that I had just been told a week ago in Sobat that there were four that they did not declare. So I told them that you must send me the names. I got the names, four of them. Two are from Tiger and two are from Mobile Brigade. So it's important we address ourselves to this issue, because it's a confidence building measure. Once we have no prisoners, no jails, it gives confidence to everybody.
Releasing of prisoners. I always say that we don't have political prisoners. I never arrested any political figure who is, you know, against me in any form. And so I don't have political details. As for the prisoners themselves, there are so many of them. But these are criminals. Other people are charged with murder and many other crimes. Should I release the prisoners who were arrested because of criminal act in the country so that they go and increase the criminality in the areas? I don't think that you yourself cannot do it. You cannot do it because if that person will go and commit a crime, that will come back to you tomorrow. And so we have done what we have done. And we will continue to do what we are supposed to do. And so when it comes to the state of emergency, the war is not yet over. Because although we have signed the agreement, there are people from the forces who are still attacking people on the roads. And that is a question that I want to ask of you. Whether any of you people watch what is happening in Yemen, if you see what is happening in Yemen on the TV, and we are still trying to insist to fight on, do we want the children of South Sudan to reach that stage that the people have reached in Yemen? I don't think that if we are really leaders of South Sudan, and that, you know, we are out to keep our people in peace and to give them what they want, we should not then take them to that stage. The pictures that, you know, they put on the TV about the children in Yemen and old people, it makes you cry. And we don't want our people to reach that state. But whatever you think that we have not done, yes, we will do it. State of emergency will be lifted when the guns are silent. But as long as the guns are still, you know, being held, there will be no lifting of the state of emergency. That is not a condition for implementation of the peace agreement. We are ready to implement the agreement, and it is already in process that we are doing on the ground. Thank you.
Mr. President, you, in our phone conversation, you also told me you were thinking of asking me and the rest of the opposition, the leaders of the opposition, to come to Cuba, even if it's 2 days. My response was more or less saying, well, what is the security? What is the security? I was concerned about it.
Because your invitation was to come. Because okay. if I don't go, why would we expect that any of them would go?
All right. I have given you my...
We all have the experiences.
I have given you my position.
They also had.
I have given you my position.
Yeah.
And you will have to, you have given me your position also.
Fine.
But you will have to, one day you will sit in one place in Juba or in Malakal or in what? One of the days to come.
Now my last point. You know that they have been still at the Obra.
Well,
I'm not allowed to go south to that. You know that. The last community.
By
Egad.
Well, if you are not going to cause any problem, you can go. Okay, I will tell the Egad people just like when Bashir told the South Africans to let you come here. I will tell the Egad also that I live here my child in Juba. Okay?
Okay.
For that issue. Thank you.